new experience. The worship service of the Eastern Star Missionary Baptist Church in Port Arthur, Texas, because of the COVID-19 coronavirus, which has affected the whole world, we now have to alter how worship goes forward. Someone has stated that worship was canceled. I beg to differ. Our worship has not been canceled. It has been challenged and changed. And because of that, we have to use new methods and new mediums to reach the hearts of the people. We do know that Jesus said that upon this rock I will build my church. The church of God is not a place. It's in the presence of him who does all things well. And so we're going to worship with you by way of a media outlet. And we pray that God will move in a special way to do all the things that need to be done, not only for Port Arthur, not only for our state, but for this whole world. We're going to ask Reverend Shepherd Jackson if he read for us our scripture this morning. Reverend Randy Baldwin will lead us in prayer. And then we're going to praise and worship together with our praise and worship team from the Eastern Star Church. God to God be the glory.
Good morning. Our scripture today will come from Luke chapter number 23 and the verse number 46. And it reads, "And when Jesus had cried with a loud voice, he said, Father, into thy hands I commit my spirit. And having said this, he gave up the ghost."
Let's have a master of prayer. Most gracious God, our Father, we'd like to thank you, Heavenly Father. Thank you for allowing us to see another day, oh God. God, we are in terrible times right now, but we know that you are God yesterday and today, Heavenly Father. God, you have healed the land before, and you will do it once again, oh God. God, we will come to you with thanksgiving, Heavenly Father, in our hearts, and knowing that you will be the one that will give us protection, oh God. God, we ask that you would bring clarity on the word today, Heavenly Father, and allow it to go into our heart and allow us to put it into action. These are many other blessings we do pray in Jesus' name. And we all said, amen.
Amen.
We are few here, but you are there. We invite you to chime in. You can let us know that you're listening and watching. And if you have a hallelujah in your spirit, if you want to say amen, if you holler real loud, I think we can hear you over here. And if we can't hear you over here, certainly you'll be heard in heaven. Now let's receive our praise and worship team. And you can welcome your church. and an awesome God. Reverend Shelvin Jackson is going to give us some leanings and some information that's necessary for this time. And then after which, we're going to ask Reverend Lester Thompson to lead us to the throne of grace.
Well, good morning once again. We want to talk at this time. We want to encourage you to continue to participate in worship, and that is by giving. And as you do that, we've come up with a new method for you to be able to give, and that is through our app. The app is called Givelify. Again, that's Givelify. And with this app, you can get it, put it on your phone. It's available on your Apple or Android phone. And we'll have those up on our Facebook website for you to see. But Givelify, you just go download the app, and then you type in our zip code 77640, and then they will give you a list of churches in our local area. If you would go ahead and select Eastern Star with the open hands, and then follow the prompts from there, it would be so appreciated. And remember that kingdom business and building must continue to go forward, and we cannot do it without you. And then also, if you would like to give, we're also still, if you want to come and drop your gift off, drop your tithes off, we have it to where you can come, drop it off. You come in to Eastern Star from the Waco Street side. You don't even have to get out of your car. You can either drop it in our drop box, which is secure. And then also, if you don't feel comfortable dropping it in the drop box, you can just toot your horn, and we'll have someone to meet you out there and receive your gift.
Actually, they can come right now.
They can come right now. Amen.
We'll be here until 12:30.
Okay.
Tell us about what will happen on Wednesdays.
On Wednesdays, we're continuing our Bible studies. And with that being said, we have our instructor, Reverend Lester Thompson, who's here with us right now. Reverend Thompson.
Amen. I want to encourage those of you who can. I wasn't really prepared to be a televangelist, so to speak. I believe we're all televangelists now. But I wasn't really prepared to do that or to be that. But it's humbling. Yes.
The
times have pushed us into that purpose. But I want to, first of all, say that I'm humbled by those that have watched it, and I'm encouraged to move forward with that. So this Wednesday at 6 o'clock, please join us for our regular Bible study. Also, I want to take this opportunity to say a word to our children, because it's easy for them to get lost in translation as it relates to everything that we're doing. We want you to know how much we love you, how much we care for you, and we want you in this season not just to seek to be entertained, but we want you to also seek to be educated. We want you to take this opportunity as a learning experience. Even though you're not able to go to school, even though you're not able to have any contact with your teachers, or anything of that nature, we want you to take it upon yourself to be proactive in your approach, to be educated, to stay educated with this in mind, that we'll come out of this and we'll be the better
Amen.
For it.
Amen.
And we want to be prepared as we educate ourselves with everything that's going on. So, children, I love you. And if your parents are watching, because I know a lot of our young people think they're too young to have a Facebook page. If your parents are watching, we want you to extend that word to our children. Now,
okay. On Wednesdays, also beginning at 9 a.m. on Wednesdays, our sanctuary will be open for prayer. We've been mandated by the county and the state that no more than 10 can gather, but you can come to the house of God and to pray, because that sense of coming is still in our heart. And so you are able to do that, and that will that will begin on Wednesday at 9 a.m. and it will continue until 6 p.m. until our Bible study time begin. And we'll be more than happy to receive you and to have prayer with you. There will be prayer persons on the in the place. And of course, we're going to do it a sound and a safe way. To God be the glory. It is now time for prayer. It is now time for prayer. That was a time because we are touchy-feely kind of people. We've been doing that, but we can touch by way of media today. And I want you to just, wherever you are, lift your hearts and your hands to God and thank him for what he's done. Thank him for what he's doing, even in anticipation of what he shall do. And he's going to show himself strong, not only to Port Arthur, but to the whole world. We serve a great God. I grew up old school, so there's an old hymn I'm going to ask Deacon Craig Chan to lead us in. It's
panic because of what man says. But we're going to find peace in what you already said to us in your word. You said that we would never see the righteous forsaken, nor see begged bread. You said to us that you can do exceeding abundantly above all we can ask or think by your power that works in us. Father, we know that you're able to do anything but fail. So Lord, we reach out and we grab your unchanging hand, because we believe right now. Father, we ask that you bless our church. Not just this church, but every church door that's open in your name. We pray right now for unity. We pray right now for strength. And then, Father, we look forward to that day. We look forward to that day where you get the glory out of everything that has taken place. We rejoice. We praise you in advance for what you're getting ready to do for us. In Jesus' name we pray. We thank you. Amen.
It is at this time that I would ask that you return your focus to the word that Jackson read for us, Luke chapter 23, verse 46. Jesus is on the cross. This is his final statement before closing his eyes in death. This is the word of assurance that he utters in relationship to his Father. He will die and he will go into hell for the sins of man. These are different days. This is Sunday. All I know, all my life, is on Sunday morning, I'm in church. That's the way I grew up. And I think, fellas, y'all can agree with me. Y'all are here to say amen, not just to be woodlocks.
Amen.
We all grew up in church. I was a church baby, raised in church, nurtured in church, fed in church, got whipped in church. All I know is church. And here it is on Sunday morning for many saints. We have the shocking reality that the church is closed. What a conundrum. But I've got news for you. There may be a restriction on the number.
Yes.
But the good news is the church of God is alive and open and well.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. We're in these times, we're challenged to call for the isolation of the sick. The isolation of the sick. People, there are many who've been diagnosed and many undiagnosed with this dreadful COVID-19 coronavirus. And we have to be cautious and careful. We have to have faith and not foolishness.
Yes, sir.
And so we have to exercise good judgment and good hygiene. There has to be the insulation of the healthy. The only way the government is saying that if this does not work, they have no other alternatives. We can look to man, but that's a limited view, but we can't look to God.
Yes, sir.
We have another issue. In times past, we have been able to help each other. When we dealt with, in our area, Ike and Rita and Harvey, people from different places gathered support and supplies and sent them our way. our land. And as they were dealing with tornadoes in the belt of our nation and floods and tsunamis and famine in many other places of this world, Haiti, as we have gone, we have been able to help them, but this unusual time, we cannot help them, and they cannot help us. So here is the sobering reality: when we cannot help each other, where does our help come from?
Yes, sir.
Our help comes from the Lord. The great debate that's on the hearts of many is, what does the future hold? And that has restricted and restrained us, called us to live with a degree of anxiety and anxiousness, worry, heartache, because we don't know what tomorrow holds. But the truth is, we don't have to know what tomorrow holds.
Yes, sir.
If we know Him.
Yes, sir.
He holds tomorrow in His hand. In the text, this is the last statement of Jesus. Having completed all of the things that had been assigned to Him by divine providence to reach the hearts of humanity and to save mankind. Having done all the things that He was supposed to deliver, just had previously just said, it is finished. What was finished? All of the eternal work of salvation. He's now at this point where He's ready to die for the sins of man. But before He dies, there is something He wants to do. He dies with this reassurance that His relationship with the Father is secure, even in death. And I think that's a word for us today, to understand that whatever we're going through, that we have God on our side, and we have help that's unseen.
Yeah.
Jesus cries out, and this is what He says, Father, into Thine hands. This is, first of all, a final resort that may be good for us today. Because the truth is, we cannot look to each other, we cannot look to the government, but we can look to the hills from whence cometh our help. It's a final resort. A resort for what? God, we need your help. Because we cannot fix this ourselves.
Yes.
We cannot legislate this.
Yes, sir.
We cannot store enough tissue in our closets. We need your help.
Yes, sir.
We need your healing. Yes. He said in His word, I am the Lord that healeth thee. We need healing. But more than that, we need His help. We need healing. But for a church people, we need hope.
Yes, sir.
We need to have a reason to continue. Somehow the old school church captured that in spite of how bad things were. They said stuff like, trouble don't last always.
Yes.
I will trust in the Lord. The Lord will make a way somehow.
Yes, sir.
It's a final resort.
Yes.
Into Thine hand is a faithful resolve. Why would we put it in His hands? Number one, because He's available. There is nothing that we go through that we go through alone. Even when we go through the valley of the shadow of death, we fear no evil because God is with us.
Yes, sir.
He's available. He's able.
Yes.
The question was raised, is there anything too hard?
Yes.
He's able.
Yes, He will.
He can do it.
Yes, He will.
And then I learned something, Randy, from your little nephew in New Orleans years ago on a bus trip. And as we're waiting on the group to come, I'm sitting on the bus with your little nephew and I'm trying. preaching points, and I said, you know, thank you, Lord, all, we say all right every Sunday. And so I'm waiting on his response. I salute you, I just said it last week, thank the Lord, all. But he wasn't getting with it. I wanted a response from him. I said, you thank the Lord, and he said, all that? I said, hallelujah. That will preach too. Because he is all of that.
Yes.
Whatever your need is,
yes,
he will supply.
Yes.
Your need. I wish I had a crowd here on Sunday morning. This is a faithful final resort. A faithful resolve. And it is for us a fruitful release. Some things you can't fix. The best thing to do, church, is to learn how to let go. Peter said, casting your care upon him.
Yes, sir.
Drop it. Let it go. I know that's hard for us because we are hands-on people. We like to fix things ourselves. But old school taught me, let Jesus fix it for you. He knows just what to do. Whenever you pray, let him have his way.
Yes, sir.
And he'll fix it. But just a little music would help me right there. Let go.
Yes.
And when you let go, you let God.
Yes.
Yeah.
You'll find out that there are some things that you've been fumbling with, messing it up. But once you put it in his hands, you discover how well he can fix it. He's able to do it. And in these times, I close with this. If you let go and let God, you will let his grace abound in our hearts. To God be the glory. How do you handle this? I think the choir would sing every now and then, turn it over to Jesus.
Yes, sir.
He can work it out. I think that's another sad song they sang, all in his hand.
Yes, sir.
I put it off.
Yes, sir.
Coronavirus 19, you're in trouble.
Yes, sir.
Because you're in his hand.
Yes.
God be the glory.
Yes, yes.
If you have not accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior,
yes,
and by way of this media outlet, this streaming to your home and your heart today, I want you to know that you may not be in a church, but you're in the presence of God.
Yes.
You're in a good place. If you confess with your mouth and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. The book says salvation is nigh unto him who call upon his name. And if you want to do that, you can do that in the recesses of your own home and your heart. Make your confession known. And he is able to save even to the utmost. If it's well with your soul, give God praise. We're going to make it go.
Yes, we are.
Somehow, you don't know how, some way, we're going to make it. Give God praise. Let us listen to our praise and worship. We thank God for them today. They're going to be busy, but we're going to get her done for the glory of God. Thank you. want to bring your gifts to the Lord, you can do that at this time. We will be here until 12:30 or until you stop coming. And we're looking for God to do great things, and just set the praise and worship said. Any day now,
yes.
And any day now,
yes,
I'm going to expect Him to do great things. That's why we're going to look to the hills. From whence cometh our help? Our help comes from the Lord. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ be with you till we shall meet again.